Hi everyone, welcome back to FinEd. Today we will walk you through a step-by-step guide on creating a Webull brokerage account for stock, ETF, and options trading. As you already know, there are plenty of brokerage firms to choose from. I'm choosing Webull account because it charges no transaction fees for stocks, ETFs, and option trading. Most importantly, it offers a paper trading opportunity with stocks and options where you can use virtual money and practice in the live market. So let's dive right in. Open your web browser on your computer and go to webull.com. Click the sign up button. I also gave the link in the video description below that will take you straight to this sign up page. By the way, you can pause the video if you feel like I am going too fast. Fill in your cell phone number and click send code. You should receive a text message with a code that you will enter in the verification code box. Check the agree to the terms clause and then click next. Now, give a password for your account that is 8 to 20 characters long and includes uppercase, lowercase, and numbers. Rewrite the password in the second box. Press the sign up button. Remember to write down your password in your notes so that you do not forget it. You'll be taken to a page that says open an account and start your investment journey. As you can see, there are different account options such as individual IRA, traditional IRA, Roth IRA, and rollover IRA. For now, I will use an individual account. Now press open account and select save my information just in case you don't want to complete your application now and plan to finish it later. Click Open Account to get the email verification page. Write down your email address and click Send Code to receive an email verification code. Check your email account that you have entered. You should receive an email with a code that you will enter in the verification code box. Click Next. Now it's time to verify your identity. From the citizenship drop-down box, select the country you are a citizen of. I am selecting the United States. From the identification type drop-down box, you can select either a passport, US driver's license, or state ID. If you select the passport, it might be quicker to verify your citizenship, but I am selecting US driver's license and then click Next. In the pop-up dialog box, there are two options you can use to verify. I am selecting option 1 because it seems to be easier for me. Take out your cell phone and open the camera to scan the QR code. Your cell phone will show a link. You just tap on it. Your phone will now ask you to scan the front and back of your driver's license. Just follow the instructions on your phone. While you are taking pictures of your ID, your computer screen will also show connecting to your mobile. At the end, you'll receive a thank you note both on the cell phone and computer. Now, you will see that the personal information page is automatically populated. Check if all the information is correct. If incorrect, you can modify it on this screen. You need to select your marital status and type in the number of dependents. Click Next. Enter your social security number and residential address. Click Next. As for the employee type, I am selecting student, but you can select employed if you have a job and then click Next. This page is about conflict of interest. You check the boxes that apply to you, but most people will select none of the above. I also select none of the above and click Next. As for the liquidity needs, I select not important. You can select anything you like. If you have selected the employee type student previously, your income information should match your status. Generally, a student will select 0 to less than 25K as net income. Select a total net worth based on your wealth. Select liquid net worth based on your liquid assets. Now click Next. As for investment experience, select a good amount. Anyways, you might be doing paper trade as your first step to the investment world. Select Growth as the investment objective. Time horizon indicates whether you are a short-term or long-term investor. Select 7 or more years. Now click Next and check if your name and SSN are showing correctly. Click Next again. Now it is asking what type of account you want to open. Cash account has no borrowing capacity from the broker. Your buying power is as much money as you have in the account. The broker generally approves this account very quickly. For a margin account, you can borrow up to 4x leverage from the broker to invest. You do not have to borrow money in a margin account unless you want to. What I mean by this is that you choose to trade using your cash and never have to borrow money. I think having an option to borrow just in case is a good feature to have in the account. Therefore, I select the margin account. Click Next. For trading privileges, check stocks and ETFs. If you like to trade options, check this one too. To earn some extra money, you can also make your stocks in your account available for lending. If you like this, check this too. Click Next. Because I checked options trading, it is now asking me what level of option approval I want. Remember, you can always apply for this later, but I am going to do it now. I will apply for level 3 options and then hit Next. I'm going to select 3 plus years of options trading experience. If you have applied for level 3, you may not get the approval if you select less than 1 year. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter whether you have the experience or not, you are going to learn it anyway. Review what each level of options trading means and hit Next. If you have applied for options trading in the previous steps, you should check High as your risk tolerance. Click Next. Now, review all the information about you. Check the box that says your information is correct and then click Next. Put your signature using your mouse pointer and hit Submit. You will now see that your application has been submitted and is being processed. Check back later. Sometimes Webull requires you to upload a picture of your social security before finally approving your brokerage account. Please note that a scanned copy of SSN is not accepted. Use your cell phone to take a picture of your SSN. You will receive an email notification whether your application is accepted or rejected. If you are still not getting the approval, even after uploading additional documents, you can call them and talk to them over the phone. In my case, after waiting a business day, I received 2 email notifications saying that my option trading application and brokerage account applications are approved. Now, it is asking to set a trading password. Click Setup Now. Enter your login password you set previously and click Next. Now, set 6 digits trading password and write it down somewhere. Confirm your 6 digits. Remember that you're going to need this password every time you buy or sell something. If you ever forget your password, you can retrieve your password by answering security questions. Therefore, set the answers to those security questions now and write it down somewhere. You will see a notification, set trading password successfully. Click back to the account and verify. Enter your 6 digits password. You are now officially the owner of a brokerage account. If you decide to deposit money now, you can attach your bank account. I'll put the link to that video in the description below. But if you want to start paper trading, you can now go to www.webull.com/trade. check the link in the description below for more. For any questions, please comment below. Thanks for watching this video.